Stand for the bride, please. You don't have to, baby. You don't have to. Giveth this woman to be married?
I do.
Thank you. All the guests can be seated. I need you on the other side. You on this side. Hand in hand. And you'll come up with a photographer till you stop. First of all, you make a very handsome couple. You really look nice together.
Thank you.
And I like to see smiles because this is a joyous, happy occasion. And it's also a very, very serious and important moment. This afternoon, the both of you are getting ready to make a commitment. I will not use the word promise during my ceremony. I won't use the word promise because we make and we break promises every day. People will promise you the day and the hour that they'll call you at home, on your home phone. There are some times you can stay home all day long. They don't even call. So what I'm trying to convey to the both of you is much, much more than our definition of a promise. A commitment is I'll go when I don't want to go. I'll do things I really don't like to do. Why? Well, I made a commitment that I would. This afternoon, the both of you are getting ready to make a commitment. A commitment that you're going to make this marriage work. Now, you realize every day will not be like today. You're going to have days when you're going to have disagreements. You're going to have days when you're going to have disappointments. That's why it's so important. This commitment must supersede. It must be larger. It must be more important than any disagreement or any disappointment you might ever encounter. I only know one way you can have a commitment that large, and that's if both of you make a commitment to God and ask God to help you in this marriage. Now, you see, God knows all about marriage, because he's the one that ordained marriage. Man did not come up with this idea. God said it's not good for man to be alone. So as long as you can remember the word commitment, the meaning of the word commitment, and who you're making the commitment to, without a shadow of a doubt, you two, you're going to be okay. Would you now please face one another and join right hands? Before we exchange vows, we're going to bow our heads in a word of prayer, let you both ask God something before you get married. Father God, before we go into this marriage, there's something we want to ask you. From the depth of our hearts, oh God, we ask you to forgive us. Forgive us, oh God, for every wrong that we've done. Not only the wrong things we've done, but forgive us for the things we should have done and we did not do. And we thank you, oh God, for forgiving us. And now that you have forgiven us, we must let all bygones be bygones. Now that you have forgiven us, we can enter into our marriage with clean hearts, clean spirits, and clean hands. And for that, oh God, we say thank you. These blessings we ask in Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen. Continue to face one another, please, and join right hands. Your right hand and her right hand. Very good. Facing one another, please repeat after me. I, Adonis.
I, Adonis.
Take thee, Geraldine.
Take thee, Geraldine.
To be. My wedded wife.
My wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
I pledge thee.
I pledge thee.
My faithfulness.
My faithfulness.
I, Geraldine. Take the Adonis. To be my wedded husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. To love and to cherish. Till death do us part.
I pledge thee
my faithfulness. May we step behind the candle table, please. Today, the two of you are becoming one. You're going to signify that by each of you taking the outside candle, lighting one in the center together, please. That represents the two of you becoming one. Blow the side candles out only, and two became one. Now we'll step back for the ring ceremony. If you notice your rings, they go round and round and round and never end. That's the way God intended this marriage to be, never ending. Do you have a ring for the bride? Upon her left hand, ring finger, I want you to look into her eyes. Say to her, with this ring, I thee wed.
I be wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son. And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
With all my hope.
With all my hope.
All my faith.
All my faith.
And all my love.
And all my love.
Do you have a ring for the groom? His left hand ring finger. Want to hold his flower? Now you will look into his eyes and say to him,
With this ring,
I thee wed. In the name of the Father,
the Son,
and the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
With all my hope.
With
all my faith.
And all my love.
For as much as this couple have consented together in holy wedlock, they have witnessed the same before God, everyone in this room, and the cameras. They've declared the same by joining hands and giving and receiving a ring. Those whom God has joined together, let no man put asunder. By the power vested in me in the state of Nevada, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your beautiful bride. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Best wishes to you.
Thank you.
What's your last name?
Thank you.
Tell her her last name.
Her last name?
Her last name.
It's probably going to be hard for
you. Yeah, I wanted her to say. She said, I wanted her to know what it is. And then him, give you another chance. Now, Mrs. and Mrs. who?
Love
She'll get it.